I have taken how you can utilize option theta for projecting the option premium, and today we will be seeing the impact of Vega in the option premium. These three are very very important things. If you are an option trader, you will be knowing these terms, delta, theta and Vega. However, to use it in the real scenario or in the real context, it requires some amount of practice, and it requires also you must do a proper calculation of that Greeks. That is very important. Without getting the proper calculation of the Greeks, it is difficult to use those things in your option price forecast. So this is the things we have learned in past 2 days. This is a series of events we have taken for the option trading, and the basics of the options we are learning. So it was a constant demand from many of you to explain the basics of option. What is a delta, how to use it? What is a theta, how to use it? And what is a Vega and what is the use of that Vega in the option trading? So these are the things I have taken in the most simplified way. So the recordings of the earlier 2 events are available here. You can view these recordings. Just you need to visit our website under seminar link, you will find out this page and you can view this recordings. And coming week, on 9th and 10th July, 2 advanced concepts are being kept, IV rank and IV percentile, and how to use that to form option strategy and how you can form an adjustment in the option strategy. If you have taken an option strategy, if it goes against you, then how, what you should do, or before you enter and you can just do a pre-adjustment so that if that strategy goes against you, that time also you should be benefiting from that. So these are the 2 advanced concepts I kept it in the 9th July and 10th July. And as I have told, this is a very basic program. So it is for the people, those who are very new to the option trading and they have almost zero skills in the option trading. For them it is being designed. So it is not for the traders, those who have in-depth knowledge on the option strategy trading and other things. So moving to the subject, as I told, if you do not have a proper calculator or if you do not have a proper software to calculate delta, theta, vega, omega, all those things, you can take the help of our web calculator. This is, you need to visit the calculator link, and the 12th link is intraday option trading calculator. You punch some data, whatever it is asking, then calculate, you get the values. So here only one, it is just taking the basic inputs given by you. So though you can rely on this calculation, however it has a lesser degree of accuracy because IV calculation is having little less accuracy in this particular calculator. But if you are using our paid software, then you get the actual IV calculations and it is real time and you get lot of benefits in that. So I will demonstrate that also. So let me move to the today's subject. Most simplified way to use the Vega. So what is the meaning of Vega? So I am not going to tell you the formulae of Vega, how to calculate Vega. All those things is the domain of a software or a tool or a web calculator. So Vega is expressed on the options expected price change relative to each 1% change in the implied volatility. So if the IV of a option, implied volatility of a option changes by 1%, then how much percentage of, or in the price terms, how much, or in the money terms, how much money changes you can expect in a premium, that is known as your Vega. And which option has the most exposure to Vega? So this is, as I told you the earlier session also, the option which is close to the underlying price, that is at the money option, having a highest exposure to the Vega, and at the money option also having the highest exposure to the theta time decay. So, and when you compare the Vega versus the number of days to expiration, option with more time for expiration have larger Vega. So as you near to the expiry, the Vega used to automatically decay. Vega used to automatically will go on reducing. So to what extent the Vega will decay, that also we have one grid to tell you that every one day you near to the expiry, how much Vega decay you can expect, how much Vega is going to reduce, like how much time value is going to reduce by theta. So same way the Vega decay also you can able to identify. That is an advanced grid also we have. However, to understand this Vega terms, the option with more time value or more time till expiry, or the more life the option has, it has a larger Vega. If the option having less life or very less time left till expiry, then you have a smaller Vega. So this is the very basic things about the Vega. So you understood, at the money options used to have higher Vega, where options having a higher time till expiration or more time until expiration having the larger Vega value. So this is the Vega terms. And one more thing about the Vega also is very common. So what is a more expensive option? Options, once you are seeing, it is a chain of options, different strikes, hundreds and thousands of strikes are available for one stop. So which strike options are expensive and which strike options are less expensive, more expensive and less expensive? So options having the higher implied volatility are more expensive. Options having the lower implied volatility is less expensive. So lower implied volatility means lower Vega decay. Higher implied volatility means higher Vega decay. So this is the, and this situation of expensive and more expensive and less expensive nature gives the opportunity of arbitrage trade in the options. This is one of the risk neutral trade, or one of the low risk trade one can initiate option arbitrage trade. But for that you will need one software to guide you. So at one point of time, what is the, which are the costlier options and which are the expensive options, sorry, costlier options and which are the cheaper options, that things you need to find through one software, or more expensive, less expensive options you can able to find out. So again, I will just take you to the backtesting. So this is the data I got. So yesterday also I have taken the same strikes, 10,700 call and 10,700 put, 10,800 call and 10,800 put. So these are the actual premiums by day end. They have closed here. 152 it has closed, 95 it has closed, 95.1, and this is also closed at 135. So opening premiums was 159, 95, 95, 139. So these are the opening premiums. Future also opened at 10,760 level, and this is current also said. So let me check it also once more. So what is the opening and where the future has closed? That also we can have a check on this so that we can get a accurate calculations on that. So that part also is very important. So where we have opened and what are the prices? So where we are closing and what are the prices? So I am going for Nifty, and this is the Nifty future data we are taking. So here the open was 10,759.95. High it has gone to 10,791. Close is 10,760. So this is opening and closing of the day is almost same here today. So opening and closing is almost same here. So these are the premiums we have in the opening stage, and these are the premiums in the actual terms. So now let us put these values. Once you are putting these values in the opening, so we have opened at 10,760 today, and day still expiry 22 days. So today is the 5th, 26th you are expiring. So 26th minus 5 plus 1. This today also we have to take in the beginning itself. So 22 days left till expiry. I am taking 10,700 call option, and the call options opening price also is very important. So let me check also opening price, at what price it has opened up. Though I have added there, but let us do some cross checking on that. So let us do some cross checking on that. So though I have already noted it down, but still we need to cross check so that there should not be any error. So the value what I have shown and the value what has happened must have some correlation, or there should be zero error in collecting the data. So the opening was 159.60, and this closing was last traded price was 153. 153 was the closing. So let me do this values here. Actual was 153. So here 159.6. So based on this particular data, once you go for a calculate, you'll be getting the IV 12.19, and you'll be getting all Greek values. What are the option Greek values? So you get the delta 0.57, you get the Vega 10.32. So each 1% change in the volatility will bring, each 1% change in the volatility will bring 10.32995% change in the option premium. So that was the, each 1% change will bring this much of changes in the option premium. And 1.35 rupees, that was the theta decay you are expecting. So we'll just enter that values. 1.35 rupees. And so this is the delta, 1.35 rupees I have entered, and 10 point Vega also I have entered 10.32995. And for this, the volatility, whether it has increased or decreased, how we will know? So for that, previously what was the volatility IV was there? What is the current IV? That is important. So current IV is 12.192. But when it has closed yesterday, what was the IV? So that is very important. So here, let us see, previous close was 163. So previous close was 163, and underlying asset was 10,766.10. So this current IV what we are getting, 12.1924. So 12.1924 I am entering here. So the volatility part, so current IV 12.1924. So this is the IV, current IV what we have calculated. So previously yesterday 123, and 163 was the price. Strike was 10,700. Strike was 10,700, and we had a price of 10,766.10, the last traded price, and 163 rupees it has quoted. So I'll just calculate it. So what was the IV yesterday? So 12.0675 or 12.0676, I can say 12.0676. 12.0676. 12.0676 was the IV. So what are the changes in the IV? So here I have to take the current IV in the opening. What was the IV? Minus previous IV divided by the previous IV. So I will get that the IV has increased by 1.03%. So it is not in percentage term. If I just multiply all these values into 100, so I will get the percentage term. So percentage term I can get it. So all these IVs I got it in the percentage term. So in case of call option, it has increased by 1%. For the two put options, 10,700 put and 800 put, it has decreased by 1.48 and 2.78%. So these are the things I have got. Now Vega says for each 1% change in the IV, 1% change in the IV, I'll be getting 10% change in the premium. So this is what it says. This is what it is saying that. So here what happens? So here what happens? If I just take the 100 multiple, so it is giving me 1.0341% of changes it has happened. But it is in the Vega also is in the percentage. This is also in 1%. So each 1% change in the volatility will bring how much percentage of changes in the option premium, that is your Vega. So Vega 1%, so it is telling me 10.33%. But while doing these calculations for projecting the premiums, you will be doing in a different way. So you may be thinking 1% is here, so 10% it is coming. So I can say that if the opening price is 1.59%, so 10%, 10 rupees 33 paisa, I can add it to here and I can find it the premium. So it may not be the same way. This Vega also percentage terms, this is also percentage terms. So what you have to do? So the change in the IV you take in the actual terms. Actual terms means without multiplying the 100. So the actual terms, this is 0.10130, whatever the value is coming, is multiplied with the Vega. So Vega impacts will be only to the extent of 10 paisa. It won't be to the impact of 10 rupees. It will be in the effect of 10 paisa, 0.106. So initially what you have done, first premium you have taken, delta you have taken, what is the changes? So there has no changes here. So this is becoming zero. Opening and current was same. So you can say that, so difference between this price is zero, so it is coming to same opening price, and you are using the delta, you are getting the same price. However, actual is 153. So the difference is 6 rupees 60 paisa. So this is the actual premium is being, and your calculated premium using the delta having a difference of 6 rupees and 60 paisa. So to adjust that, what we have taken the theta. So theta is telling that 1 rupee 35 paisa decay it is expected. So after the decay of theta, you got 158.24. So that theta part, if you reduce, its value comes to 158.24. So actually it's 53. So earlier the difference was 6.65 rupees. So it is being reduced to 5.24 rupees. And then you are just adding the Vega. So Vega of all these call options and put option is giving 10.35, 10.40. So this Vega, when multiplied with the absolute terms of your volatility change, so it gives you 158.35, 92.96. So if you just compare here, so in case of 10,800 call options, slightly it has improvised. The difference is slightly improvised, and 10,800 put option also it is slightly improvised, and in case of only 10,700 put and 10,700 call, it has slightly expanded. So 10,700 call and put, the Vega has slightly, Vega increased, volatility increased, has slightly expanded. However, the call options of 10,800 and 10,000 put ups, 10,800 put option and 10,800 call option slightly got narrowed down. The difference has slightly narrowed down. So initially the difference was 6 rupees and here 15 paisa, 20 paisa, here 3 rupees 80 paisa. So after the theta impact, it is greatly got adjusted, and after the Vega impact, still it has got further, two strikes got further, difference is further narrowed down, and two strikes it has expanded. Why it happens? The reason is the IV. The IV what we have taken it here, and the IV what we are calculating in this web calculator, it is not having that much of improvised method of, or if this web calculator doesn't have an improvised way of projecting that IV. So this IV what we are calculating, for calculation of implied volatility, there is no direct formula. All of you will be knowing that. There is no direct formula for calculating this implied volatility. So how this implied volatility is being calculated? So to calculate this implied volatility, we have to start with one volatility of 0.5 or 1, and we'll just go on incrementing and comparing the option premium with this, and we'll find out one place, okay, the option what we are getting premium and what we are calculating, it is just in line. So this is the IV. That is one process. Second process is we have to take some of the numerical methods like your bisection method, bisections method, like your Newton-Raphson method. So these are the methods also you can utilize for calculating the IV. And many other methods which is giving a greater accuracy, that method also we can utilize. So the difference, if you use the software and use the web calculator, so you can say now 10,760 is the Nifty and 22 days is left in expiry. On the closing basis, if I am going to show you, so here I am taking 10,700 put option, I am taking, so 10,700 put option, as I have shown you, the 10,700 put option, so 10,700 put option as 95 rupees and 20 paisa it has closed. So here I will be taking the 95 rupees and 20 paisa, 95.20, and calculate. So this gives me an IV of 14.95. So 14.937466, this is the IV again in the web calculator. However, if you use our paid calculator, so paid calculator, what is the IV is coming? 13.1. So this difference is a great difference, because here we could able to simulate with more conditions, we could able to simulate with more precision. So this IV also is being improvised. And many of you will be looking at the IV of the NSE website. So here too also NSE gives one IV. So here too also you can say, if I take the put option, the 10,700 put option I have taken, just calculated also. So if you see the IV given by the NSE, so here they are giving 14.06. So this IV also, they followed a different method of projection. However, if you use this IV of 14.06, you may not get this premium at all. So this is also one of the gray area of this information which is being given by the NSE. So here, though they have given the interest rate, whatever the things they have informed, if you use that things in any of the pricing model, you will not get. So here they have given 10% interest rate is being used for computing the IV, but that same won't work out here. So that also I can show you here. So if you have studied the option, and if you have any option Excel sheets, if you have any option Excel sheet, and if you just simulate it here, today's closing was 10,760.22. 10% interest rate, I am going to get for 10,700 and they have given me 14.05. So this premium comes to, put option premium comes to 93 rupees and 32 paise, as per the IV given here. So IV is 14.06 and premium is 95.20. however, if you just simulate the same thing here, 14.06, if you make it, the premium you are getting only 93 rupees, not 95. To get this premium, you need to again further increment it to get the things. So these are the some of the ways many people think that the IV given in the NSE site is accurate, which is not correct. So here, at least 14.93 you are getting here, some amount of accuracy is there. However, if you just go for the calculator, it gives you the exact IV. So this 13.13 of IV, if you can utilize in any of the pricing model, you will get the exact premium. So this IV also real time, I think. What is happening in this NSE side, the real-time price is not being taken for IV, rather it may be a delayed price being used for computation of IV, and this price, the real-time price, is not being filled for computation of IV. There is a delay factor which is just giving a different IV, and this IV of 10%, 15% difference makes a huge difference for your premium forecast. And say if you are an intraday trader, you day trade in the options, then it is also a great differences it can give. So this part also they have. Someone has asked that whether we can use this future or spot. So now let us take two in the money options. Say 10,600 call option is a in the money option, which is having, if you take spot, it has 149 rupees as the intrinsic value. It is trading at 220 rupees. So there is a, you can say 20 here, 51 there. So 51 plus 20, 71 rupees of time value. So same way, I am just taking one in the money put option. So 134 rupees it is trading. So if I consider the time value and intrinsic value, so time value 49, so here, so 50, 134. 0.5 minus 50. So this is what the, if I less it here, 84 rupees and 50 paisa as the as the time value. So this particular time value difference of one is having 71 and another is having 84 rupees 50 paise. Why this difference? Can anyone tell me why this difference of time value when we consider two different in the money options? A lot of people are hedging with the put option, so demand of the put options are more, that's why the volatility is more. Demand of the call options are less, that's why its ID is less. This is what it says. But how I can utilize these things for a trade? You have seen the very basic concept, delta how it impacts, theta it impacts, vega it impacts. So IV, if it increases, then the premiums, vega will increment the premiums. If the IV decreases, then vega will decrement the premiums. So you got one call option and a put option. Perhaps the put option having a higher IV, put is having higher IV as compared to the call option, and calls are having lower IV. So this is you are getting here. So can you suggest me as a trader, it says that puts having higher demand, that's why the IV is more, or more number of puts are being utilized at this particular time for hedging as compared to the call options, then also put IVs are more. So many meanings you can, theoretical meanings you can draw from that. So can anyone will suggest me what kind of plan or strategy or what kind of risk neutral approach I can utilize so that I will make benefit in the trade, same time my exposures will be lesser. So in this kind of situation, when you encounter this kind of situation, more number of puts are having, or put demand is higher as compared to the call demand. So then one factor always I used to say, look into the difference between their IVs. You are getting these IVs. So look into the difference between the IVs. If you put IVs are excess by the call IVs, this is little advance, by 30% or more. If the put IV is X and call IVs are X plus 30% or X means lesser than the X minus 30%, or call IV is X and this is for call IV and the put IV is X plus 30% of X. So 30 divided by 100 into X. So if this is the situation, if put IVs are greater than this, then you can say that trend is up, more number of traders are hedging on this, and these puts are being utilized for the hedging in more number of cases. So our put writings are happening. Then second, you have to go with the put call ratio. PCR for the Nifty, it is not valid for any other counter except Nifty. PCR analysis of Nifty, that already I used to say 1.168 above. So above this, if PCR maintains, then it is a uptrend. When you fall below 0.85, it is valid only for Nifty. Below 0.85, you can say that you are in the bearish trade, and as long as you maintain between 0.95 to 1.05, you are in a sideways trend. So this is what it says. Can anyone will tell me one simple strategy? You have understood the role of delta, you have understood the role of theta, you have understood the role of Vega also. So how Vega impacts? And Vega, using the Vega also, you have a very good arbitrage trading opportunity available in the smart IT tool. You get into this arbitrage, so you will be knowing that based on this IT differences, what are the actual premium, what is the fair value. So how much arbitrage opportunity is there? So 10,650 call option having 8 rupees or 9 rupees of arbitrage value. Lesser. So this should be the value. This is the value actually this trade. So here 1 rupee 65 paisa is having the arbitrage value. So if you want to form an arbitrage trade, so if you want to form an arbitrage trade, what will be your call? So 10,800 call option having 2 rupees more value, 10,700 call option having 1 rupee 65 paisa less value. So you can buy 10,700. You can sell 10,800. This also you can do. So by this process, 2 rupees 39 plus 1 rupee 60 paisa. So it is 3 to 4 rupees, 280 rupees of arbitrage value you can utilize. Even you can also utilize with the 650 and 700. So here 2-5 rupees differences are there. So this arbitrage opportunity, though it is in the closing basis, every day morning when the market opens, if you start using this option arbitrage tool, sometimes it will be 12 rupees, 13 rupees arbitrage values also will get. Some stock options also will get higher values. That time you can make use of that. So now coming to the small strategy, but using this particular concept what we have understood. So here you have put options high, having higher IVs, call options having the lower IVs. So lower IV means it is less expensive, higher IV means it is more expensive. So what I am doing here, once I go for the next month, so this is the August month, can I experience the same kind of phenomena? Yes, call options are having lower, put options are having the higher IV. So if I form a net credit calendar spread, so when you form a net credit calendar spread, you must look into the strike which is having the highest open interest in the July in the put side, which can act as a resistance, act as a support. So here it says that 10,600 is having a highest open interest, so it can act as a support. So you can buy this options at 65 rupees, the 10,600 call option, put option, you can buy 10,600 put, you can buy at 65 plus, and same time you can sell August 10,600 put option. So August 10,600 put option and take the credit. So 10,600 put option, which is at 120. So 120 you can sell, 65 you can buy. So almost 55 rupees of credit you can receive. After getting this credit received, utilize this particular credit to buy a call option. So this is as a support, so it is not going to fall. So this 55 rupees I am going to utilize as a sum, as a capital for my call option buy. So I can think of a call option of, you can say, 10,800, so 95 rupees it is costing. So 95 rupees I can buy. So 55 less means the cost of the call option I reduced to 40 rupees. So it is the expectation of uptrend. If the uptrend goes out, then I will be making good money. If the downtrend comes, then this 40 will be a loss for me. However, if there is a calendar spread increases, then I will have a further loss also. So this kind of strategies also you can form by looking into the IV, and these strategies you are forming because of Vega. So because of Vega. So this kind of strategies also you can form for your benefit. You use the delta, the calculated premium or projected premium and actual premium having a big difference. Once you put theta, the difference is further narrowed down. And once you put Vega, it is further narrowed down. However, this IV must be real time to give you the correct Vega estimates. The IV difference must be real time to give you a correct estimation of the option premium. So these are the three different things you have understood. So using that, I have told, if the IV of the put options are more than 30% as compared to the call option, that says put has a higher demand, put writings are happening, puts are used for the hedging of the long position. In that situation, to form a net credit calendar put spread, means next month put you will be selling and current month you will be buying, it must be the preferable strike will be the current month strike, put option strike, which is having the highest open interest. So form a net credit put spread, utilize that credit to buy a call option. So that will be the best approach to trade in such a situation when the trend is up. When trend is down, you have to do in a reverse way. Registered for the upcoming event, which is on the two advanced concepts, IV rank and IV percentile and option adjustment techniques. If you have not registered for this program, you can please register, forward it to your friends, ask them to register for this program. Regarding our products and services, we have a futures and option course, which will be a very valid course for the option strategy trader. If you are interested, you can go for that course. So it will help you a lot to understand the option strategy. And same way, we have the all courses and softwares. If you are switching, then it will cost you 18,490. And this is a valid course, means you get all our courses, all our softwares along with the WhatsApp group support. Since in WhatsApp group, you are getting various option strategies on real-time basis. So that is available only for the full package buyers. Only for the full package buyers, that feature is available. So lot of option strategies will alert you when to exit. We'll alert you when to form the adjustment. It is only for the full package buyers. So any product related queries, you can call to our support number. And in fact, last time we have run one offer where anybody is buying option strategy software, option course used to be given free to them. So same thing I am extending to all you participants. And in the full package also, time to time we give some offers. And some of the people are asking whether I can get the products in the earlier offered price for the full package, which was given earlier at 15,500 plus GST of 660. So plus GST of 660. So this earlier is being given in this rate. Right? So 15,500 plus 660. So if you wish to get that, just call to our sales number and express your interest on this. So that, and as a participant of this event, I can extend this offer to you. So you need to call and ask for the payment gateway so our people can help. So this is the numbers are given there. So with this, I am ending today's session. And hope you have